Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. To kick off this video, there is news of the company called Intuitive Machines selecting SpaceX to launch a lunar mission to the moon. This article on their website says, Intuitive Machines continues its mission to build a cislunar economy with its third mission, IM-3, to the moon that will launch on a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket. The IM-3 mission includes a Nova C-class lander to land 130 kilograms of payloads on the lunar surface. It also has excess capacity on the launch vehicle that accommodates 1,000 kilograms of payloads on a rideshare dispenser ring that deploys into a lunar transfer orbit. There is an article posted about two new ships spotted being outfitted for possible Falcon 9 fairing recoveries. It says, a photo was shared in a Facebook group that appears to show two vessels in the midst of being outfitted. The post shared a tip that SpaceX purchased these two ships for operations on the East Coast. One of the vessels clearly brands a SpaceX logo while the other is being worked on and sharing the same color scheme. Gavin Cornwall posted a tweet about this saying, I can confirm that SpaceX is building two brand new ships. Bob and Doug are designed as an all-purpose solution to tow and support drone ships offshore and also recover fairing halves. The ships have been under construction in Louisiana since May and are due in Florida very soon. Michael Sheets posted a tweet saying, NASA's Inspector General says delays in spacesuit development are another factor making a 2024 astronaut moon landing impossible. With $420 million spent and another $625 million expected, suits won't be ready for flight until April 2025 at the earliest. Musk responded and said SpaceX could do it if need be. Tom Mueller responded to Michael Sheets' tweet with, I think we developed Falcon 9 and Crew Dragon for less than $1 billion. Musk then responded and said, yeah. Over in Boca Chica, here is a view of the orbital tank farm construction. The yellow structure at the launch site continues construction and is now being painted black. Work on the other structure at the launch site for the launch tower also continues. The cryotank shell work continues at the propellant production site too. A cryotank shell was rolled out to the launch site. There was also this label spotted on the cryotank shell. The cryotank shell was also hooked up to a crane for sleeving. You will likely know about the whole HLS awarding fiasco with the GAO recently denying the protests from other bidders. Christian Davenport posted this tweet saying Blue Origin just not giving up on the HLS program. Says the GAO's decision highlights issues that will prevent the US from landing on the moon and says it is concerned about SpaceX needing 16 launches with limited flight readiness reviews to get Starship to the moon. Musk responded to that and said 16 flights is extremely unlikely. Starship payload to orbit is approximately 150 tons, so max of 8 to fill 1200 ton tanks of lunar Starship. Without flaps and heat shields, Starship is much lighter. Lunar landing legs don't add much, 1/6 gravity. May only need half full, i.e. 4 tank of flights. Musk also posted another tweet about this saying, however, even if it were 16 flights with docking, this is not a problem. SpaceX did more than 16 orbital flights in first half of 2021 and has docked with station much harder than docking with our own ship over 20 times. Somebody posted a tweet saying, all the things that we humans tend to fight for seem so small and petty compared to the very thought of taking first steps on Mars. Musk responded with, what really matters for the longevity of civilization is making life multiplanetary on a sustained basis. The ground support equipment tank GSE-7 was recently stacked in the midbay. The heat shield tiles on the Starship 20 nose have a bunch of markings as they prepare it for orbit. Crews continue to work on Super Heavy Booster 4 at the launch mount as it prepares to move back to the production site. The Booster 4 prototype has since been moved off the orbital launch mount. Two sections for Super Heavy Booster 5 have already been spotted. To finish up today's video, thanks to Brendan Lewis, we have an updated Starbase production diagram. As always, I have to say thank you to Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, who is out in Boca Chica all day every day filming the amazing content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working hard behind the scenes on their great videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.